आर्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ॐ पाराय प्रतिबोधिताम् भगवता नारायणेन स्वयं व्यासेन कृतिताम् पुराणमुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम् अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणी भगवती अष्टादशाध्यायिनी अम्बत्वामनुसन्दधामि भगवद्गीते भवद्वेषिणी यं ब्रह्मा वरुणेन्द्ररुद्रमरुतः सुन्वन्ति दिव्यैस्तवैः वेदैः साङ्गपदक्रमोपनिषदैः गायन्ति यं सामगा ध्यानावस्थितगद्गदेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यं योगिनः यस्यान्तं न विदुःसुरासुरगणाः देवाय तस्मै नमः।
Second verse.
यं संन्यासमिति प्राहुः योगं तं विद्धि पाण्डव नयः संन्यस्त संकल्पः योगी भवति कश्चन।
There are two types of persons. One is grahastha, does the karma, but anashritaha karma pada. Anashritaha karma pada means trishna rahitaha or karma pada. He has no hankering for results of action. This is my duty and therefore he does. He is not running after the pada. Other person is an actual sannyasi, paramartha sannyasi. Actual sannyasi, vidhivat as per the vidhi, one who has given up the karmas. He doesn't do any karma. Now, Lord Krishna equates these two both. Question is, from what point of similarity these two are equated? Ashikara says, from the standpoint of karta, the doer, in the sense, the disposition, the mental disposition. In both, the grahastha who does the karma without the Krishna for karma phala, and a sannyasi who has taken to sannyasa, giving up all the karma, their disposition, the mental outlook is one and the same. From that standpoint, the grahastha also is called as what? Sannyasi. But not mukhya sannyasi. Not actual sannyasi. Secondarily is called as a sannyasi. The question was, what is the point of similarity that is now being elaborated by Bhashyakara?
Yahi. परमार्थ सन्यासी सः त्यक्त सर्व कर्म साधनतया सर्व कर्म तत्फल विषयं संकल्पं प्रवृत्ति हेतु काम कारणं सन्यस्यति।
So, first, what is the actual position, status of a mukhya sannyasi? Well, he is described as what? Paramartha Sannyasi. Paramartha Sannyasi means the Sannyasi in the true sense, actual Sannyasi. Second one is not actual Sannyasi. Who is he? Grahastha. Second is not actually. This is actual Sannyasi. So what he says, Yaha he, one whoever he may be, it is like this. Who is he? Paramartha Sannyasi. An actual Sannyasi. What does he do? Saha, that person. So he gives up. What all he gives up? Sarva karma sadhanataya. Tekta sarva karma sadhana. Tekta, one has already given up. What? Sarva karma he has given up. Sarva karma sadhana he has given up. Any difference? He has given up all karmas and he has given up all the karma sadhanas also. What is the difference?
What is that?
If simply gives up karma and keeps the sadhana, let us anyway again take to karma. So he has given up karma and karma. Do you know what is that karma sadhana? He has given up home and heart. First number one, wife. Why wife? Not that account to settle with. Wife is the part of what? Karma. Without wife, he can't do the karmas. So he has taken sannyasa means, he has given up the wife means, he is no more eligible to take to karmas, sadhana. Again, vidya, etc. Money. See, Vedic karmas are not cheap, okay? They are very costly. Olden days, Brahmanas used to go to king and ask for the money and they used to give. Otherwise, if they had themselves, then they are not. Even poor people used to, poor Brahmins also used to, but they used to get the money, very costly. So he said, now here, he has given up karma, sadhana, vitta, patni, griha, everything he has given up. So that is the sadhataya. Again, sarva karma tat phala vishayam sankalpam sannyasi. Sarva karma tat phala vishaya sankalpa. Sankalpa, desire, hankering for all to perform all karmas, to get the results of all those karmas, vishayam pertaining to sankalpa. See, sankalpa word has got many meanings. In short, it can be crystallized as manovyapara, function of the mind. But you have to take specific meaning in the particular context. So here, desire, hankering, karma phala, trishna. So that is what is there. So the sankalpam, sarva karma phala, tat phala vishayam, sankalpam. What is the sankalpa desire? Pravritti hetu kama karanam. See, to perform karma, first what should be there? Motivation must be there or no? I should get something. So that, what is that motivation? Phala. The desire for phala he has given up. There is no reason why he has to take to karmas. So pravritti hetu, see pravritti hetu rupa kama karanam. Desire, which is in the form of the hetu, the means, the motivation to take to performance of the karma, karanam, what is that? Desire, sankalpa, sannyasyati. So what mukhya sannyasi has given up now?
Karma,
karma sadhana, karma phala, trishna. And therefore, he has given up everything. Now, what about this grahastha? He has got all these things. No, he doesn't have all these things. He has got karma he has got. Karma sadhana he has got. But karma phala trishna, he doesn't have. So that's So what about this grahastha?
Ayam api.
Karma yogi.
Karma kurvanaha eva.
Phalavishayam sankalpam sanyasyati.
Iti etam artham darshayan aha nahi.
Yasmat.
Asanyasta sankalpaha abhisandhihi yena saha asanyasta sankalpaha kashchana kashchidapi karmi yogi samadhanavan bhavati.
Ayamapi, even this person, this person grahastha, who was that person?
Sanyasi.
He is also communicated with the sanyasi. He is the mukhya sanyasi, actual sanyasi. Ayamapi, who is a karma yogi, he performs the karmas, karma yogi. Karma purvanaha, performing the karmas. Karma purvanaha eva, even while doing the karma. Karma purvanaha eva. What does he do? Phala vishayam sankalpam sanyasyati. Sankalpa, desire, trishna, hankering for karma phala. What does he do? Sanyasyati, he gives up. Iti etam artham darshayan ah. This to reveal, to tell this meaning. Bhagavan. See, where in second line now, Bhagavad Gita, that is verse 2. Not he, meaning is yasma. Because such a person with that asanyasta sankalpa, no one who is not asanyasta sankalpa can be what? A yogi, a person who has got chitta samadhan. Let us see. He, yasma, asanyasta sankalpa. This phrase is split and analyzed. Asanyasta. What is sanyasta? Paritekta, kiroha. Na sanyasta, asanyasta. Not given up. Asanyastaha means aparityaktaha. Aparityaktaha means na parityaktaha, means one who has not given up. Na parityaktaha. What when they have not given up? Phala vishaya sankalpa. Sankalpa, that hankering, the desire, that wanting for phala vishaya. What is sankalpa? Bhashyakara says, abhisandhihi. Abhisandhihi. What is abhisandhihi? Intention, purpose, or desire. Or like this. I am this type of planning. I am doing this to get this result. Abhisandhihi. Connecting. I want this, therefore I am doing this abhisandhi. Intention, purpose, or kama, desire. Abhisandhi, yena, because of it, he has given up this abhisandhi, therefore saha, vidu, saha, asanyasanga, one who has not given up such abhisandhi. So yena, that is what is there, no is there somewhere, where? Nahi yasma. See, this is problem in Sanskrit. The sentence continues in many lines. In the beginning, na is there, and at the end, verb comes, You forget the law, that's why. You know, that chance is, those children, they said, Lada Madhone Paripata Kela Magi La A Visarunagi. Alphabets, no? O A E E U. You need to see, okay? You will not X, Y, Z. ABCD forgotten. Lursi, Yara Lava, Lava Shashasa, Yara Lava Shashasa, La Kshatya. Now say La. La La Li Li Lu Lu Le Le Lu Lu Magiga. So like that. So we have come to the end of the sentence. Beginning, Na forgotten. One were not given up. Na sanyasta sankalpa. So that is, one were not, one were saha, asanyasta sankalpa. Then it is to be taken with the na. So one were not given up the sankalpa for this sankalpa. Kashchana. Kashchana means anyone. Any grihastha, kashchidapi karmi, any grihastha who does the karma, yogi, who is yogi here, samadhanavan, who has got the disposition to make the mind get absorbed in the sarupa, bhavati, with this bhavati, then na is to be brought, na bhavati. It doesn't become na bhavati. What do we have na bhavati? That na bhavati is for the next day.
Na sambhavati.
Na sambhavati.
Iti arthaha. Fala sankalpasya.
Chitta vikshepa
hetutvat.
Na sambhavati iti artha. It's not possible for him. So long as karma phala trishna is there, he can never expect to have a composed mind, a quiet mind that can take to dhyana. The reason he gives, phala sankalpasya chitta vikshepa hetutva. See, chitta samadhana means what? Free from vikshepas. What are vikshepas? Agitation. What is the cause of agitation? First is it. See, modern people should take a lesson from this. The modern people are after what? Meditation. What for meditation? Peace of mind. And such packages are from 5-star hotel onwards, so up to some classroom in the school. So if they go up, depending on your purse, capacity of your purse, they have got. This principle is, you know. So long as you have got desire, never hope to have peace of mind. He gives reason for the sankalpasya, that hankering for results of action means fulfillment of the desire is what? Chitta vikshepa hetutva is the hetu for chitta vikshepa. Is the cause of what? Agitation in the think of. I say, from where it starts? First, I want. Then he knows, without doing something, that desire cannot be fulfilled. And I must do this, etc., planning, etc. To plan and do, all means may not be there. Then run after the gathering the means. And again, whatever done may not be up to the mark also. So there is no guarantee that result is going to come, whether I will get the results or not, etc. So then the result has come, not up to the mark, or sometimes above the mark also. So then, whether I am able to enjoy or not. And suppose you are able to enjoy. I think this is not what I want. This is not what I expected. Tell what, and then I think that is better. This, I made a mistake here. That is better. And go after that. And afterward, there also what? So that thing is. They always vikshepa, vikshepa, vikshepa. You know that in Bhagavata, example is given by hawk. Hawk is a very fast flying bird. It got a piece of meat, mouse. A bird, Bhagavan is kind enough. So he has given a nice breakfast today and picked up. By the time other hawks, they started chasing it. And this hawk started running. Running, this somehow dodging them, etc. For half an hour, this struggle was going. The hawk got so exhausted, it simply dropped that piece of meat. Where are other hawks? Shanti, shanti, shanti. We are all hawks only. So we don't want to give up like that big, like a snake eating a big frog. You know, a snake eating a big frog with the size of the mouth. Neither it wants to give it up nor it can swallow it. So that is how it is. This desire can never be. You know, thoda samajhne ki baat hai. और समझने के बाद क्या है? वैसा आचार होना चाहिए. Otherwise, not one life, 1,000 lives you may be studying Bhagavad Gita under top masters. You are where you started when 1,000 lives. 1,000 lives are there. So, first discover that. Once you have discovered and brought in your life, 50% of your job is over. Afterwards, Vedanta is a smooth ride with the blessing of permission. Isko hi samay lagta hai. Not to complete Bhasha book. Chittasi phala sankalpasya chitta vikshepa hetu. See, desire phala is the root cause, not root cause is ajnana, is the main cause for what? The chitta vikshepa.
तस्मात् यह कश्चन कर्मी संन्यस्त फलसंकल्पः भवेत् सः योगी समाधानवान् अविक्षिप्त चित्तः भवेत् चित्त विक्षेप हेतोः फलसंकल्पस्य सन्न्यस्तत्वात् इति अभिप्रायः.
See, that's another way. In many such congregations, what they do, vairagya aspect, they are little sidetracked. No, why? Audience will reduce. This is what is called as what? Playing to the gallery. Playing to the gallery. Softening it. Just playing to them, to cater to their pimps and fancies. At least I can't do. You know why? Where I am sitting is called Vyasa Peetha. I have to be honest and faithful to whom? Shastra. It is not possible. So So that's why some may say, वो अच्छा है ये बार बार वैराग्य 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 बोलता है इधर दे आर गुड सीज दे गो टू सच एन एक्सटेंट सी कृष्णा हैड मेनी वाइव्स दे आर्गुमेंट कृष्णा हैड मेनी वाइव्स कृष्णा समबडी सेड डू वन थिंग यू हैव टू वाइव्स एंड कीप देम हैप्पी If Krishna had many wives, he kept all the wives very happy. You have not many, only two. And keep both of them happy. That's why he is infinite. This is not. This is generally, I told in the sense of, these are some without the speakers. They say Krishna had many wives, etc. It's going on. This was by Pooja Swamiji. Christian missionaries, you consider Krishna as Bhagavan God? He has so many wives. He said, that's why he is God. See, he had 16,000, they said, 16,000 wives, and you consider them? Exactly for that purpose I consider as God. You have two wives and keep both of them happy. Let me see your capacity. The other wrong notion. Krishna had 16,000 wives. Not so. See, Narakasura was killed at the hands of who? Krishna didn't kill him. He didn't give the honor of killing him. He brought Satyabhama. Why? He inserted woman from the hand of woman he killed him. So he was riding the horse, the chariot, but he Satyabhama killed. And 16,000 captive women were released. And Krishna said, I have freed you, now you are free to go back home. That was not modern time. A woman in the house of someone is not acceptable. Said, Bhagavan, you know, we are not acceptable. You are alone our bharta, they said, Bhagavatam. So you are alone our who? Bharta. And these people made, bharta means husband. No. Bharta means protector. Husband also is called bharta because he is a protector. Nowadays, who protects whom has to be investigated. Whether husband protects the wife or wife protects the husband, that has to be what? See, nowadays, olden days, wife was, see, patni, pati, pati iti pati, pati means protects, that way is pati. So, bharta, protector, you are, see, he took care of them. That's true. Because they are on streets. There is, so, there's 16,000 wives. Okay, we accept it. In spite of that, he was who? Ajarma Brahmachari, you know that story? See, one day Krishna told all queens, see, on the other side of the Yamuna, a great Mahatma has come. Feed him, serve him. Some good punya will come to you. They went. With all plates full of fruits and all sorts of snacks and this and that, food and all that, all human. Yamuna is in what? Floods! How can they cross it? So they said, Krishna, Yamuna is in floods. Oh, achcha. I'll go and tell Yamuna, if Krishna is Ajanma Brahmachari, give. He's telling his wife, Ajanma Brahmachari, give him the way. They went, Krishna says that if he is an Ajan Brahmachari, give the way. Yamuna gave the path. They went. And then they saw the Mahatma, a skeleton, what time will pop off? Can't be stone at all. And they gave all the offerings, etc. And to their surprise, he ate everything. ప్రసాదినేర్క లేట్ ఇస్ సంథింగ్ టు ప్రసాదం దిగదే దే వాట్ ఫ్రైటెడ్ సో హౌ విల్ డైజెస్ట్ ఆల్ దిస్ ఎనీవే సో హి బ్లెస్డ్ దెమ్ ఎట్సెట్రా అండ్ ఇట్ అగైన్ యమునా ఇస్ ఇన్ ఫ్లక్స్ అండ్ నౌ వేర్ కంట్ హార్ట్ కృష్ణ కృష్ణ ఇస్ ఆన్ ద అదర్ సైడ్ సో దేర్ ఫర్ ద ఓన్లీ రెస్క్యూ ఇస్ హూ దిస్ మహాత్మా దే వెంట్ టు ద మహాత్మా అండ్ సెడ్ భగవాన్ యమున ఫ్లడ్ వి కాంట్ క్రాస్ డోంట్ వర్ డోంట్ వర్ గో అండ్ టెల్ యమునా if this mahatma has not eaten the food if this mahatma is not eaten the food give the way they went the mahatma says that if he has not eaten the food he will not give the way do you know from what standpoint they said this brahmadhyani their eye is not in the body atma akarta this is brahma they were so absorbed so that is how it is anyway So now here, so that is that level has not come. See, what I am telling is, these such statements, sidetracking the main thing, cater to the masses, to the, just to play to the gallery. You may have a nice way of spending time, some with the what, little maja, adhyatmic progress is not possible. Delay is here. So that is why, see, even our Shastras, for a person who doesn't have Vairagya, who has got lots of desires, they cater to him. You know, this is what they do. See, if you have got this desire now, for this desire, this is the karma you do. For this desire, this is the karma you do. Means they give the means of fulfilling. But the means of fulfilling are based on dharma, not adharmic. You fulfill your desire, but by the means as given by who? Vedas. They are dharmi. And because of taking to dharmic means, no doubt, they are bound to fulfill the desire. In the long run, the mind becomes disciplined, viveka dawns. And the person slowly starts thinking. And that viveka leads to where? Vairagya. See? Veda is catering to the demand of this person. But in a such a way, there is a built-in device kept in the long run, he is bound to what? Develop what? Viveka Vairagya. Once Vairagya developed, he is bound to take to this person. So that is, any individual has to develop Vairagya one day or other. That one day may come after millions of kalpa. It may come after millions of kalpa. Now it is left to you to accelerate the progress or keep it as it is. You know what is accelerating progress? By vivek etc. what? Make it fast. That is left to you. So but this principle keep in mind. No one can enjoy peace of mind when riddled with the desires. Chitta phala sankalpasya chitta vikshepa hetutva. Sankalpa, desire or phala is the cause of, the main cause of agitation in the mind. Continue.
Evam परमार्थ सन्यास कर्म योग योहो कर्तुं द्वारकं सन्यास सामान्यं
अपेक्षा
यम सन्यासं इति प्राहुः योगं तं विद्धि पांडव इति कर्म योगस्य स्तुत्यर्थं सन्यासत्वं उक्तम्
तस्मात्
यहाँ कश्चन कर्मी संन्यस्त फलसंकल्पः भवेत् सहायोगी समाधानवान अविक्षिप्त चित्तः भवेत् चित्त विक्षेप हेतोः फलसंकल्पस्य संन्यस्तत्वात् इति अभिप्रायः.
Tasmat, therefore, what is that therefore? Because, what is it? Phala sankalpa is chitta hetu. Keep in mind, phala sankalpa is chitta vikshepa hetu. Not chitta hetu, chitta vikshepa. Tasmat. Yaha kashchana. Anyone who is that karmi, sanyasta phala sankalpa bhavi. He does karma, at the same time what does he do? Phala-sankalpa, yes, given. Okay. Saha, that person is who? Yogi. Who, what do you mean by yogi? Samadhanavan. What samadhanavan? Chitta samadhan. Mind is what? Mind capable of getting absorbed in the deya. Capacity is done. Vikshepas are not done. What do you mean by samadhanavan? Avikshipta chitta. Na vikshipta chitta. One whose mind is not agitated. Avikshipta bhave. So he becomes. Why he becomes avikshita? The cause of chitta vikshepa is given up. What is a chitta vikshepa heto of the cause of chitta vikshepa, namely phala sankalpa sanyasatva, that hankering for Krishna, for phala, what he has done? Yes, given up. Iti avipraya. This is what is the tapariya. This is what it means. We already, one second.
Evam paramartha sanyasa karma yoga yoho
paramartha sanyasa karma yoga yoho
kartru dwarakam sanyasa samanyam apeksha yam sanyasam iti prahuhu
yogam tam vitti pandava
iti karma yogasya
stutyartham
sanyasatvam uktam
evam paramartha sanyasa karma yoga yoho. In this manner, eva means what? As explained hitherto. Paramartha sanyasa karma yoga yoho. Of these both, what are those both? Paramartha sanyasa. What is paramartha sanyasa? Mukhya sanyasa. Karma yoga yoga. Karma yoga. Grahastha doing karma, giving up karma phala Krishna. So among these both, kartru dwarakam, through the karta, means from the standpoint of disposition of their mind, the disposition of mukhya sannyasi, the disposition of the karma yogi, sannyasa samanyam apeksha. Apeksha, depending on the samanya, similarity of sannyasa. What sannyasa? Karma phala sannyasa. That is what he says. In the first verse, Lord Krishna says, yam sannyasa iti prahu. No, second verse. Whatever that is called sannyasa, tam yogam bindi. Same thing, no one understands the word yoga. Pandava iti karma yogasya sutyartham sannyasatvam ukta. To praise karma yoga because it leads to that disposition to take to dhyana. So it is what is that? It is what? Equated to what? Sannyasa. Krishna doesn't mean, as we already seen, it is not mukhya sannyasa. Karma yogasya sutyartham, to praise karma yoga. Sannyasatvam, kasya sannyasatvam, karma yogasya sannyasatvam. Question comes, this person with a grahastha who has taken to karma yoga with Trishna Rahitya, how long he has to take to karma? When he can stop the karma, what is that demarcating line? So that is now being explained.
Dhyana yogasya. अधुना कर्मयोगस्य ध्यानयोग साधनत्वं दर्शयति.
So, prastavana, introduction to third verse, arukshoho iti. Why Lord Krishna has said this, whatever that is told in third verse, reason is this. Dhyana yoga, see, context is of what? Dhyana yoga. Because it is the antaranga sadhana, direct means to make the mind absorb the sarupa. Dhyana yogasya phala nirapekshaha karma yoga bahiranga sadhana. The external means to take to dhyana yoga is karma yoga. Then, what karma yoga? Phala nirapeksha, wherein Krishna hankering for phala is not there at all, is not there at all. Phala tar nirapeksha, karma yoga, bahiranga sadhana. What is this bahiranga sadhana, antaranga sadhana? Antaranga sadhana, we may say inner means. What is meant by inner means is direct means. Bahiranga sadhana, we may say external means, it means indirect means. So, in train now, there are what? Through trains is what? At one junction it stops, it terminates. You take another train, you reach the destination. There are direct trains. You get in, and then what? There are through bogies. You sit in a bogey at a junction. Railways will what? Take that and join to the other thing. You are sitting in the bogey only. Yes, sir. So now here, Dhyana yoga is antaranga sadhana directory. Karma yoga is bahiranga sadhana indirectory. I think better take directory, no? Dhyana yoga. To go to Delhi, bullet train is going to come now. Firozpur Janata Express also is there. You know, there is a train called Firozpur Janata Express. I don't know. 28 hours or something, it's been taking, I don't remember. To Gorish, Delhi. Bullet train, 10 hours. On next flights, 2 hours. What determines? Your purse. Your purse determines what you are capable of. So can anyone say, a lay person who doesn't have money, can he afford for flight or bullet train? None of it. You have to take two. According to me. So Dhyana Yoga, that what should be there? That disposition must be there. No. I will take the best. I will straight away go to PhD only first. Yes, some catch and data. Lower KG, upper KG, primary, higher secondary, higher primary, secondary, higher secondary, college, postgraduate, project, kya hai, center hai PhD. Can you? So that is how it is, you have to, that is eligibility must be. Says, karma yoga is bahiranga sadhana, indirect means, iti, tam means tam karma yoga. What karma yoga? Not simple karma yoga. Phala nirapeksha karma yoga. Phala nirapeksha karma yoga. Karma yoga. Sanyasatvena stutva. Stutva. Having prayed. As what? Sanyasatvena. Sanyasatvena. As sanyasa itself. It means this person is bound to become a yogi, yachita samadhanava. Aduna, say, karma yogasya, of this karma yoga, dhyana yoga sadhanatvam darshayati. Phalanirapeksha karma yoga in the sadhana, the means of dhyana yoga is being took. Where? In this verse, arukshoho iti.
Arulukshohuner yogam.
Arulukshohuner yogam.
Karma karana mucchate.
Karma karana mucchate.
Yoga rudasya tasyaiva.
Yoga rudasya tasyaiva.
Shama karana mucchate.
Yogam arukshoho munihe karma karanam uchyate. Karma karanam yogarudasya tasyaiva shavaha karanam uchyate. Yogam arukshoho muni. Let us first see this arukshoho. First you know arukshoho, then tasya, sixth genitive. With arukshoho, praptum ichhu. One who desires to gain it. His, tasya means his. Arukshoho means the one who wants to take to Dhyana Yoga. Munehe, Vidis Muni, Karma Phala Sannyasi. Karma Phala Sannyasi. Grahastha has taken to Karma Yoga with Phala Trishna. Rahitya, he is called as Muni in anticipation. Because first step he has already taken to. Munehe, karma is said to be what? Karanam. Karanam means, Karanam means, Uchyate is said to be the means. Now, Yogarudasya tasyaiva. Yogarudasya. Actually, what is meant by Yogaruda? Bhashyakara gives the meaning in the next verse. Yogaruda means Prapta Yogasya. One who has already got the capacity to make the mind absorbed in the Swarupa. Yogarudasya means one has already accomplished the yoga. The Saiva, not any other person, same person, with that same person earlier who had taken to Karma Yoga to get the capacity to take to Dhyana. The Saiva, Shama Karana Mucchati. Karana, sadhana, means what? Shama. Shama here is Nivrutti, withdrawal from karma. So long as he has not got the capacity to take to Dhyana Yoga, take to karma with a Phala Trishna Rahitya. Moment you get that capacity to take to Dhyana, drop the karma. You churn the curd until the butter is formed. When the butter is formed, stop churning. So shamaha, shamaya, withdrawal from that karana means bhashya.
Arukshoho, arodhum icchataha, anarodhasya, dhyana yoge avasthatum ashaktasya eva, iti arthaha.
See, arukshoho. What is meant by arukshoho? Arodhum icchataha. Arodhum means praptum. Ichchataha. One who is desirous of gaining Dhyana Yoga means capacity to take to Dhyana. Armune Ichchataha. Who is he? Anaruda Sya. Presently Anaruda. What is Anaruda? Aprapta Yoga. Presently he doesn't have the capacity to take to Dhyana. Anarudasya. What is Anarudasya? Dhyana yogi avasthatum ashaktasya. One who is incapable of taking to Dhyana yoga. One is capable of incapable taking to Dhyana yoga meditation. Now see, be careful about this word Dhyana yoga, because this word meditation is for everything you. Even japa also is called a meditation. Not that way. Here Dhyana Yoga is making the mind taking to contemplation of Nirguna Brahma, wherein all drishyas are not. See, even upasana, see manasa puja, etc. can be secondarily called as dhyana, meditation. But that is not a meditation here. Your mind totally absorbed in the Nirguna Brahma. See, different words are there. Japa, upasana, manasa upasana, manasa puja, such things are there. But nowadays in English, meditation, meditation, meditation. How is wondering? It's subject of meditation. What is this? You know what is actual meditation? Thinking of one thing to the exclusion of other, that's all. All of us are meditating. On what we meditate first, that's all. See, people complain concentration of mind is not better. When you see the serial, how much? How much concentration is there? The youngsters watching cricket match, how much concentration is there? Are we lacking? No. Why? See, concentration is not there means you have no interest in that. Simple. Is this true? Wherever there is interest, concentration is bound to be there. It's the nature of the mind. So therefore, there's no point in complaining, I don't have concentration. Develop interest. Achha, interest can be developed. No, there are many ways. You know, see, first find out the plus points in what you develop. Automatically what will happen? Mind. Otherwise, no. Pooja Swamiji didn't like Karela. Swami Dayanji. She used to go for, in the olden days, she used to go for Bhiksha from a different person. And Karela is there, what used to say? Let me finish this first. Let me get rid of it. So you see, the hostess thing, he likes it. Again, she used to serve. Sannyasi can't do it, she can't say don't, etc. So then, within no time, due spread, Swamiji likes Karela. Wherever he goes, what is that? So he said, I started liking Karela. Liking Karela, liking Karela. So like, not that way. So you develop that interest because sign them plus points. See that? Plus points. Yoga Tasya Yogam with this Anaruda Dhyana Yoga Avasthatu Ashakta Seyu Ashakta incapable of taking to Dhyana Yoga or to abide in Dhyana Yoga. Tasya, what is that tasya?
Tasya, avrukshoho muneye,
karmafala sannyasinaha iti
arthaha.
See, first line told, one who is still incapable of taking to Dhyana Yoga has to take to Karma Yoga. Tasya, for the same person who was referred to where? In the first line, now, when he has got the capacity, drop the karma. So before that, tasya, for him, he is, who is that? That is explained. Tasya means, avrukshu ho mune, was referred to in the first line as a muni who wants to gain the dhyana, dhyana yoga, means, namely, karma phala sannyasina ityartha. The grahastha who takes to karma with a karmic attitude, giving up of the phala trishna. And when that grahastha gives that capacity to take to dhyana yoga, drop them with.
शुभमस्तु नित्यं लोका समस्ता सुखिनो भवन्तु काले वर्षतु पर्जन्यः पृथिवी सस्य शालिनी देशोऽयं शोभरहितः ब्राह्मणा सन्तु निर्भयाः ॐ सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः सर्वे सन्तु निरामयाः सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग्भवेत् असतो मा सर्गमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्योर्मामृतङ्गमय ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्ति